Hello there, and what we're going to be talking about today in today's video is a look at some of the snipers trades for last week. In fact, really just for Friday. So I'm going to do a little bit different to the usual sort of trades of the week and just go through a number of the sniper trades on some of the major markets that really took place on Friday there. But really what we're looking at with these this particular strategy, it's a very simple strategy to use, so it's great for new users and it can pick up some good sort of scalping moves. And what we're looking for from a 15-minute chart is just a very quick move of sort of 20 points or so. And in fact very good for picking up some of those moves against the trend of the market. And so what I'm going to do is just go through the 13 snipers we had during the main part of the day on Friday. So from 7 o'clock right through till about sort of 3-4 o'clock, and have a look at those, all the opportunities from there. Now I'm going to start off with dollar Swiss, just to go through what we're talking about there. So the first thing to really mention, I guess, is that we've got our sniper circle. That's the yellow disc with the green outline around it. And really what we're looking for from there is this line to also change direction as well. And this is what we call the vector average. So on the basis that we would enter here, what you're then looking for is about a 20-point move to the upside. Okay, so we're looking at getting in at around, what, 95.40 or so, looking to get out at, what, 95.60 or so. I think it was 38 and 58 there, give or take there. So actually, 38 was your entry here. Targeting 58, just managed to get it. Although even if you didn't actually manage to get out here, it of course certainly got up into that zone a little bit later on. So this is what we're really looking for. So entry, stop below where the market's just been. Okay, so here's my stop loss. Target around sort of 20 points or so. We're gonna look at the same target for each of these moves. Now some of these aren't the best risk reward, but it doesn't really matter because they're picking up some fantastic success rates. Out of the 13 trades I'm gonna show you right now, 11 of them went on to hit their 20-point target, picking up about 166 points over those 13 trades. So that's pretty nice. And let's just have a look further on. So the entry is dollar Swiss. Remember, this is at 10:15 on Friday morning. Entering one at 95.38. High here is 58, so just made the 20, but of course with the stop below here, even though it tested back on that 130 data, still then ultimately went through to hit that target, even if you didn't quite get out here at 11:15. So a nice move on dollar Swiss there. Let's have a little bit move further. So gold. That's your first trade of the day was here. Now you notice the sniper's actually gone. The snipers only go so far back, so you can't always see them on the trades, but there was a buy here. Obviously, you know, I wouldn't be showing you this trade if there wasn't a sniper. So there's the buy here, and this trade really just went against straight away. Very, very poor move. But, you know, so be it. You know, it was a loss, and really, you know, it's just part of the thing that that happens, I guess, on certain trades. But doesn't matter. We chalk it up as the part of cost of doing business, I guess. Let's move on to the next one. The next trading opportunity we had was on dollar yen. Now that kicked in just here. Again, the sniper's only going so far back. Nice one in the afternoon, but I'm not here to talk about that one. We had a buy here at 53s. 100 spot 53 went up to here. 100 spot 74. Okay, so it moved, what, 20, 21 points or so with a nice tight spread. Hit the target and certainly moved on very, very nicely from there. Okay, so 2 out of 3 so far. Let's move on what else we had there for the day. So dollar yen, sterling yen also kicking in at a similar time. That was at 11 o'clock as well. So here's your buy here. So you can see how the snipers kicked in. You're then waiting for this line to catch up. It's red, it's red, it's red, it's red. Now it goes green. So how the price closes above that green line here, the vector average line. So there's the buy. 152.83. So as the first target, I'm looking for 153.03. So where does it get it? On this bar here, just before 2 o'clock. So again, nice move and another winner there on sterling yen. So that's currently running at 3 out of 4 so far, hitting that 20-point move there. Remember, all you need to do, £10 a point, 20 points, that's 200 quid profit potentially on that trade there. Very, very straightforward. Dollar CAD. There's a lovely short here. This is my trade of the day on Friday. Absolutely textbook short. Sniper, as I say, can only go so far back. So as we are mid part of the way through Monday, we've sort of moved on a little bit from there, so we can't see it. But that trade was very much there at the time of the day. 11.45, 103.49. Actually went down to my ultimate target, down to the lows of the price envelope there. You'll see more from that from the trade of the day from Friday. But notwithstanding that, even if you're just going for that 20-point target, down to 29s. There's your target done straight away. 4 out of 5. Let's move on. Next trade we caught was Euro Yen. Okay, again, there's your buy around sort of 12 o'clock in the, what, the 50s, 56s. Market then rallied a good 50 points plus, okay, within the next few hours. So again, now running at 5 out of 6. Moving through now to the DAX. Next trade we had on the DAX kicked in here, 11:30. 83.27 was the buy. So the sniper, waiting for that indicator then to turn from red to green. Buy on the close, 83.27. Remember, looking for 47 as that first target. Touches it, goes nicely through it here come 1 o'clock anyway. So again, another profit. Similar trades are happening on a number of indices at the same time. Again, 11:30, S&P 500. There's your buy. There was a short later on, but say, don't want to talk about that. Just talking about this long for now. Really nice, easy to identify buying opportunities. Anybody can jump on trades like this. Very, very simple to get into. S&P's there, another 20-point plus winner. Oil, there's a buy there. This is US oil, so NYMEX crude, 92.95. Rallies about 30 points. Okay, easy, straightforward. Anybody can jump in these trades. Brent crude, 11:30. Doesn't make my 20 points. Stops about 5 points short, reverses back down, stops me out. That's my second loser. Okay. Remember, 11 out of 13 trades were profitable on this day on Friday. US 30, next one, Wall Street, the Dow. There's your buy again. Top of the price envelope. Either way, 20 points achieved. 15248 was the entry. So looking for 68. Does it quite get there? 66 is there, has a little pullback, and then rallies from there to the target. This is all you're looking for, guys. Pullback, sniper, red to green. There's your 15248. There's your buy. There's your entry. There's your target. Okay. Moving further through, euro dollar. Again, there's your entry. Again, you can't see the sniper now, but it was certainly there. 129.89. Points hit, spikes through it a little bit more, so you're certainly over in just gone 1:30 there, and again another 20 points there. And then just finally, to top it all off, a little bit of action on FTSE there at midday. So again, 65.92, looking for what, 12s there. There's your target, hits it just before 3 o'clock, and you're out before the end of the session. So I think the key point to really ask yourself is, you know, can you get on trades like this? You know, because they're very easy to identify, I think. And all we're looking for is this sniper disc here, the green outline suggesting an up reversal. We're then looking for this vector average turn from red to green. Closes above that green line here, that's your buy, 65.92. How easy is that? It's all you really need to think about. From a 15-minute chart, that market should then move a minimum of 20 points there. Very, very easy to identify trades. 11 out of 13 on Friday. 17 out of 18 on Thursday. And so far today, we've won quite a few trades. We're still in quite a few trades on Monday, but we've already had 6 winners and 2 losers. That's not too bad. That's running at about on par. So very, very nice moves and very easy to identify those trades. And I think the key thing is, it's easy, it works. Can anyone do it? It's just a simple question of red and green, guys. And if you need me to change the colors to any other color you want so you can get jump on trades like this, all you got to do is ask. We'll change the colors to whatever you want. Thanks very much for listening. Hopefully you found it a useful video.
If you would like more information about trading the right way, Trendsignal is giving you the opportunity to see and hear about its services live at a free online seminar. Take a look at the Trendsignal website for the latest events and to book your free place.